Ben DeCrenza coming in from Legends Martial Arts. His coaches, Eugene McDonald, Adam Colorile, and Mikey DeVia. Training for 3 years. Coming into the ring here at 2-1, and all of his wins have been by unanimous decision. He warned us, he said his knees are very dangerous. He's been working on them, and he's been trying to perfect them.
And you know what? To your point, he does come from that Muay Thai heavy background, so it makes sense that, listen, this is going to favor him. You know, this striking format, while it's not like Muay Thai, it is similar in some regards.
There's some overlap with the skills.
And of course, the man sharing the ring with him, a fantastic talent in his own regard, AJ Haryu. AJ, 3-0 in kickboxing, 1-0 in MMA, still undefeated. As we talked about, that controversial decision he won over Nick Vasquez. Had a lot of people calling for a rematch. AJ didn't allow himself to be stuck in the noise and just stayed true to himself. And he's out here tonight to make another statement, stay undefeated. Last fight, we saw him much more aggressive, and he has power in stage, but he can also fight off the back foot. Don't get it twisted. AJ Harlock, about as talented as they get. He does have a tendency, and fans watching at home should note this down, is that he does have a tendency when he throws strikes to kind of lean his head back. And you see there, they must have put a precedent on that in fight camp for his opponent, Ben DeCrenza, because you can score easily on Haryu with leg or head kick, excuse me. He does have a tendency to kind of keep his head off the center line when he throws.
First of three scheduled two-minute rounds here. Liam Tarrant and Jacob Coop Cooperman joining you here at K-Series.
Nice cross there from...
Ooh, wow, oh, wow, solid goodness. Left hand. That was a nice left hook there from Horlick.
Horlick also doesn't deal well with pressure. That's one thing that we need to note. Nick Vasquez, a lot of the reason people thought he won that fight was because he was constantly pressuring. That is one way that you would go about beating a man that is as talented as Haryu.
Oh, nice right hand from AJ Pretty Boy Horlick.
Live up to the name. He's a handsome man.
Ben Credenza looking to change that if he can, and land some shots on that head.
And good boxing from DeCrenza.
Yeah, DeCrenza using that reach really nicely.
Absolutely, yeah. Usually we see AJ, who's the guy that kind of fights off his back foot, stays wide, stays on the outside, likes to utilize kicks. In his last fight, he was a lot more aggressive, and that's an adjustment he's kind of made. Perhaps for this one, he might be taking more of a back foot type of role, because that is where he seems to be at his best. But DeCrenza's pouring on volume there. Nice boxing.
Oh, that looked like a stumble there. Almost to the back of the head, it did seem like that.
DeCrenza had said something to the referee about that. Nice body kick from both men.
Now, when you got a guy like DeCrenza who's got sharp punches and a long reach like that, keeping the guard a bit low again on the part of Horlick is a bit dangerous.
Yeah, and there you go again. See, DeCrenza knows that AJ sometimes will lean his head back, and right there he scored with the head kick.
Nice solid jab from Horlick.
And you tell the power of both men.
I was going to say, they are both going for it here. They are both going for kill shots here.
And I love when you get in the ring with someone and it's like the entirety of the round, you guys are jawing at each other, and then in between, it's like, all right, man, hey, good job.
Yep, all right, on to the next.
Yeah, absolutely. Trying to take your head off, but hey.
That's the game.
You're also trying to take my head off. It's all respect.
It is respect before and after, but of course, business between the bells.
Yeah, absolutely. And I talked to a lot of fighters pre-fight about how they handle certain times at weigh-ins when they're super-duper complimentary of each other. Because I know some guys need to make it personal, right? Like, some guys enjoy feeling like they are at odds with their opponent, or there's that trash talk aspect there. It's not just a mentality thing. Some guys enjoy just being a little bit more hostile because it kind of gets their mind in fight mode.
Every fighter is different in the way they got to motivate themselves and get going, but it's never anything personal.
Yeah, no, absolutely not. Absolutely not. And DeCrentis' corner yelling at him to keep his guard up, to your point. You know, he was keeping his hands down a little bit low there.
Horlick fighting out of Sensatori MMA. Coach Ray Rivera there as we get this second of three scheduled two-minute rounds underway.
And you hear the crowd. AJ perhaps has a home field advantage. Nice cross there. Screaming his name.
Wow.
Barely misses with the uppercut there. And one of those head kicks might land in a big, big way. AJ's really got to be careful of not leaning his head down. And you see again, DeCrenza's just trying to load that up. Every time AJ gets his head off the center line, nice offense from DeCrenza. Every time he gets his head off the center line, DeCrenza's looking to score with that head kick.
Nice solid left hand there from DeCrenza.
His nickname should be The Credentialed. Just confuse everyone.
Solid hand from AJ coming in. Nice
jab,
stiff jab.
His head back.
You can see the stance difference too.
Yeah, AJ, we know this is like kind of the wide stance that we know and love Hardy for. He likes to keep it wide. It helps mobility, and he likes to circle too. Very mobile fighter. Doesn't like to stand in front of guys.
Usually a bad idea just to stand in front of someone.
Yeah.
Unless you're winning the exchanges.
Or unless you could just pour it on. And, you know, we've got a couple guys tonight that like to just go all out.
Dig in, bite down to the mouthpiece, and start swinging.
Rely on your offense. Yep.
But that not the case here with AJ Horlick.
Yeah.
Oh, nice right
shots.
Hand lands.
And, of course, Horlick's O on the line. DeCrenza's doing a good job, though, of just staying calm.
Nice head kick, but DeCrenza, Horlick comes back with a nice set of punches for him.
Yeah, this has been back and forth here. It's one of those fights where you don't even want to try to even judge it in your own head because it's so hard to tell. That might have been a knee there that got caught with by AJ.
Second round comes to a close. We go into the final round. I think that second round was all Horlick. DeCrenza is still dangerous, landing some shots, but I felt the momentum overall is going into Horlick's direction. What do you think?
There was definitely, to your point, there were some junctures in that fight where DeCrenza really had AJ on the back foot. And that's not to say that AJ can't handle that, but you combine that with DeCrenza's fantastic boxing and volume. Yeah, there were some big times, some big junctures in that round where DeCrenza was scoring big. And so I want to pose this question. What do you think each corner is telling their athletes right now? If you're DeCrenza's corner, are you saying more volume, more pressure? If you're AJ's corner, you're saying, hey, we need a little bit more pace out of you. I mean, what do you think adjustments?
I think DeCrenza's got to pour some of that boxing on and watch his defense a bit. Horlick seems to be doing pretty well. I mean, I'd keep using those angles. I wouldn't stand in front of him like he hasn't been doing. He's been applying his game, playing well. I think DeCrenza's got to try to trap him into a corner, maybe get him against the ropes, take his mobility away and just start pouring it on.
That is one of AJ's best attributes, is his mobility, his ability to keep that wide stance and attack you at angles. So, to your point, you take that away and you can start to unload.
And that almost a Philly shell type stance for Horlick.
Yeah, very interesting.
Ooh, nice right hand landing for him.
And it's interesting because you look at the bottom half, right, of Haru. It looks like more of a karate stance, but then if you look at the top half of DeCrenza, he keeps his hands open and square, almost like a Muay Thai or even like a point karate type of style. Nice overhand scores for Haru. Big third round tilt here. Minute left.
1 minute remains
Both
in this fight.
Both these guys are swinging out of their shoes. front kick opportunity attempt there, I should say, from DeCrenza. DeCrenza's pouring it on now.
Nice hands there.
Agee's doing a good job of not letting himself get crowded with his own offense. He's firing back.
Wow, multiple shots landed for DeCrenza.
Agee might be a little bit wobbled.
I would like to see a fight like this go five rounds.
Oh, my goodness.
If I had my choice.
Absolutely. Sign me up for three more rounds of this.
This is going into Krenz's moment. The momentum is going for DeCrenz, in my opinion, right now.
Oh,
in
these
last 30 seconds. But does he have enough time
to
possibly get a knockdown?
Fantastic third round. 20 seconds left. Probably too little, too late, can we say? Is that fair to say?
Not sure. I think it's been pretty close. Yeah, he's really made an impression in this third, though.
Absolutely. Just also pushing the pace and making it more of a claustrophobic affair for Hoyuk.
Horlick coming back in the end of this round here. Wow.
Ended off in a big way.
I tell you, I don't envy these judges having to judge that fight.
Oh, my goodness.
That's tough.
Like I said earlier in the fight, it's like I'm watching. We're commentating, right? We're supposed to be the guys that describe what's going. And I honestly couldn't tell you who won that one.
It's tough when you're in the middle of it and like calling one side and then the other watching them both.
Yeah.
It's actually hard to be a judge. I used to judge for the New Jersey State Athletic Commission. It's a hard job to judge because if a guy's ahead in the beginning of the round, but another guy comes ahead in the end of the round, do you judge it even? You got to give the round to somebody. And then if somebody, they'll say you can almost steal a round by really putting on a good performance the last 30 seconds, but if you lost everything up to that point, it's a very tough job to do, and it's draining. It's very hard to do.
Absolutely. And as we talked about, I mean, like, we talk about the referees having a thankless job. The judges? I mean, come on. You get it right, nobody knows you exist. You get it wrong, the entirety of the internet is talking, at least at the highest level.
I'd much rather be here at the commentary table with you, Coop, than at the judges' table with
absolutely.
Them.
Absolutely. This is more fun anyways.
Oh, yeah.
We talked about it, this is not necessarily fight related, we talked about it, commentating is one of those jobs that everyone wants to do, but few can do well.
And we go to Mike Falvo for the decision once we get this second set of shin guards off.
Yeah, shin guards, all right. He's going to just leave it.
Let's hear it for these two great fighters and one hell of a fight, ladies and gentlemen. And now we go to the judges' scorecard. Judge number one scores the fight 30-27 in favor of the blue corner.
Wow.
Judge number two scores the fight 29-28 in favor of the red corner. Judge number three scores the fight 29-28 for your winner by way of split decision. Out of the blue corner, Ben DeCrenza.
Ben DeCrenza,
wow.
Doing a fantastic job, yeah, with his boxing and applying that. I agree that should be a split decision fight,
yeah,
there. The 30-27 threw me off a little bit there.
Listen, it's not our job again.
Sure.
All we could do is commentate, but that, I agree, that was a questionable decision on the one judge's part. And you could see the audience going mad for DeCrenza. Of course, he's able to take away Haruk's you got to think that he's going to be back better than ever. I think a loss can teach you much more than a win would ever.
Oh, absolutely.
You know?